My Little Girl, written by Cracked Inkwell. Chapter 11, of Generosity and Kindness. After breakfast, it was agreed that Lauren should get some proper clothes to wear so her pajamas can get cleaned. Of course, Rarity volunteered to make her something new to wear. Just give me some materials in about an hour, and I'll have her wearing something civilized. Celestia led Rarity to the workroom for the royal tailor to have her work. When Lauren and Rarity went into the workroom, they were amazed to find the place was a library of material, with yards upon yards of every materials, patterns, buttons, lace, buckles, feathers, and anything else either of them could think of. As amazed as Lauren was, she couldn't help but notice that Rarity looked like a kid in a candy or toy store for one.
Look at all this, Rarity said, darting from fabric to fabric. Silks, wools, even cotton! Oh, the possibilities of all the dresses and suits I could make with all of this! Dear, she turned to Lauren, even though you may wear one of my works today, I am obligated to make sure that you look glorious. And that is not a guarantee, but a promise. But first things first, I need to measure you.
Rarity took out a long measuring tape, taking notes on numbers of her height, waist, arms, legs, and even her feet. Rarity took out some brown paper and placed them over her, drawing and cutting out pieces.
What are you doing? Lauren asked. Making out the pieces for your clothing, dear. Since I've never made clothing for a human before, I need a different pattern so you would be comfortable wearing it.
That made sense to Lauren. Rarity studied the pieces that lay before her.
Let me see what I can do with this.
She took out a notebook and started drawing. Lauren couldn't help but take a peek at the other drawings.
Those are so pretty.
Rarity couldn't help but smile.
Why, thank you, darling. Those are just merely sketches. You should have seen the real thing. You know, you kind of remind me of a pony from the show.
What show?
My Little Pony.
Rarity raised an eyebrow.
That's a rather odd-sounding name for a show. What's it about?
Ponies, mostly.
Alright then. So, which pony do I remind you of?
Sparkler. She likes fashion stuff too, only she likes everything and anything sparkly. She even makes dresses that sparkles.
Sparkles? Really? Why, darling, sparkles are so last year. Nowadays, it's sapphires.
Oh, that's good, come to think of it.
Oh, by the way, you do wear dresses, right?
It wasn't too long after that. Rarity took out three different kinds of blue fabric, measuring, cutting, and sewing them together with one of the sewing machines in the room. Putting sapphires here, a pocket there, she came up with a light blue skirt with white buttons, dark blue pants made out of cotton, and a royal blue silk overcoat where her stitch patterns and sapphires really stood out. By the time Lauren got a chance to take off her pajamas to replace them with the blue clothes and got a look at herself in the mirror, she fell in love with the clothing.
I love it! I wish I had something this nice back at home. I never had clothes tailored for me before.
Rarity gasped.
That's full abuse! You never had any clothes tailored for you?
No. Mom or Dad always buy our clothes because they're already made. Never had one made around me. Except for some Halloween costumes.
But this is not a costume at all, dear. It's meant to be worn. Oh, and before I forget,
Rarity levitated a pair of slippers that were as white as a cloud to her.
Much better. And you know what? You can keep them.
The slippers?
And the clothes. You can have them for all nothing. Really? You mean it?
Lauren squeaked in delight. Why, of course. No one should ever live without clothing that's tailored for them. Of course, it is as a form of generosity. Now, let's get these pajamas washed. In the royal gardens, there is an aviary which provides homes to birds from faraway lands, from owls from the frozen north to birds of paradise from distant tropical islands. It was time for these birds to be fed, and amongst the few ponies feeding them, Lauren and Fluttershy were there.
I know. I agree that it's a good day for flying, Fluttershy said to a crowd of chickadees. But I was told you must be patient. Please eat first, though, before you go flying.
Do you know what they're saying? Lauren asked.
Oh, yes.
Fluttershy said, giving the chickadee some seeds, hiding her face behind her wing all the while. Not much of a talker, huh? Fluttershy shook her head. There was a moment of awkward silence until there was a crash. At the sound, she saw Fluttershy jump high in the air with a loud eek before hiding behind Lauren. As it turns out, the crash came from a Pegasus who knocked over a bucket of seeds, and now the birds were flocking everywhere towards the mess. The Pegasus tried to shoo them away, trying to make sure they didn't get overfed. Lauren turned to Fluttershy.
Can't you do something? Okay,
she said quietly. She went over to the birds and quietly said,
Excuse me.
Most of the birds stopped eating and turned to Fluttershy.
I know that you're all hungry. I understand that. But don't you think... you should wait your turn? I mean, all of these ponies are trying very hard to get all of you fed. And if I remember correctly, some of you already have eaten. So... would you please let us clean this up while the other ponies can feed you all properly?
And to Lauren's amazement, not only did these birds understand, but they did as they were told. They left the mess of seeds alone.
How did you do that?
Lauren asked.
I asked them?
She answered tentatively.
But how come? How come they listen to you? Oh, it's rather simple. Sometimes, when I ask an animal nicely, they do it because I'm kind to them. It usually works better if you're kind to them, to give them respect and to help them understand. That is, if that makes sense. I think I get it. So you're saying that if you be nice, you can get everyone to do anything? I don't make someone do something. I just ask. That's all. So, can you please help me clean up?
And that was chapter 11, To My Little Girl, written by Cracked Inkwell. So, now with this chapter and the next few following chapter, it seems Lauren is definitely going to be spending time with the main six one-on-one to get to know them better. That's actually a good thing. In fact, when she leaves this world, maybe at the end, she uses everything she might remember to create them. Of course, that should go without saying. Anyway, it is a good idea to spend time with them one-on-one. That way, she gets a better outlook on everyone's different perspectives. So, in the next chapter, I wonder who she'll be spending time with next. I think it's Rainbow Dash and Pinkie Pie. Oh boy. With Pinkie, we can only imagine how that's gonna turn out. I'll definitely have to practice a lot more for her voice. Anyway, I am Lotus Moon, and I wish you all a good morning, afternoon, evening, or night wherever you are, everypony. Good night.